In this video, you'll see how to perform online parameter estimation and fault detection using System Identification Toolbox. To demonstrate this, we will be using this hobby DC motor connected to an Arduino Uno board through a driver. The embedded algorithm running on the Arduino Uno tracks the reference angle commanded to the motor. The algorithm also performs online parameter estimation and fault detection to calculate a fault flag that we see on the scope. During the normal operation of the DC motor, the fault flag is set to 0. However, when we apply a load to the motor, the embedded algorithm quickly determines that motor dynamics has changed and sets the fault flag to 1. When we remove the load, the algorithm detects that motor dynamics is back to normal and sets the fault flag back to 0. I will emphasize again that the online parameter estimation algorithm is running on the Arduino Uno board and is detecting changes in motor dynamics as they occur. Let us now take a look at how we implemented this algorithm using Simulink and System Identification Toolbox. We used the Simulink model and automatically generated code from it to program the Arduino Uno. Let us take a closer look at this model. It has two main parts. The first part is a simple PI controller that we tuned for reference tracking. The PI controller takes the angle tracking error and generates voltage commands for the DC motor. The angle reference signal is small enough to keep the DC motor within its linear operating conditions. The second part of the model is the online parameter estimation and fault detection algorithm. We provide the voltage command to the motor and the measured motor angle as inputs to the recursive polynomial model estimator block, which is present in the System Identification Toolbox. We configured this block to estimate a polynomial model of the DC motor with an RMAC structure, that is, autoregressive moving average model with exogenous inputs. We also added the error port and the enable port by selecting the appropriate options in this block. We used the enable port to perform online parameter estimation for the first 10 seconds of the experiment. This enables the estimated model parameters to converge to steady state values. After 10 seconds, we disable online parameter estimation and the block holds the estimated parameter values constant. This will help us detect changes in motor dynamics. The error port outputs the one step ahead prediction error, that is, the difference between the measured motor angle at the current time and its estimate from the block. We pass this prediction error through a low pass filter. This filtered signal is the input to the fault detection algorithm, which is implemented using a simple two-state state flow chart. The state flow chart sets the fault flag to 1 when the filtered error is greater than a threshold and resets the fault flag back to 0 after the filtered error is less than the threshold for 10 seconds. The model also sends signals of interest, that is, prediction error, and the fault flag to the host computer so that we can observe the experiment results in real time on the host machine. Let us now generate code from this model and load the generated code onto the Arduino Uno. Once this is complete, let us start our experiment. The scope here shows the one step ahead prediction error, its low pass filtered version, and the fault detection flag. By the time we disable adaptation at 10 seconds, the parameter estimation converges and the prediction error is close to 0. When we apply a load, the prediction error shoots up and the fault flag gets set. When the load is removed, the prediction error falls, causing the fault flag to reset to 0. To summarize, in this video we showed how to use System Identification Toolbox to implement online parameter estimation and fault detection on an embedded processor. This concludes the video.